Hello everyone, welcome back to InfoScience. Today, let's discuss the fourth phylum of the non-chordates, that is the phylum Platyhelminthes. So, let's discuss about it. Platyhelminthes. So, these are also known as flatworms. They are dorsoventrally flattened body. And its symmetry is bilateral symmetry. So this is the first group in the animal kingdom where we see the bilateral symmetry. They are triploblastic, that means their body developed from three germ layers, that is the ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. And they have the organ system level of organization. They are acoelomate, means they have no cavity inside their body. And one of the important characteristic is that they exhibit the cephalation, that means the formation of head. So here, though their body have head, but here the brain-like structure is not developed. Now, let us know about the habitat. So here, most of them are endoparasite. Example, liver fluke, tapeworm, and few are free living. Example, planaria. Next is the excretion. So here, in Platyhelminthes, they are ammonotelic. So here the nitrogenous waste which they eliminate is the ammonia, for which they have some special cells which is known as the flame cells or solenocytes. So this is another important characteristics of the Platyhelminthes, that they have the special cells which is known as the flame cells. Now let us move to the digestive system. So in Platyhelminthes, the digestive system is absent in the endoparasite, but it is present in the free living, that is in the form of incomplete digestive system. Next is the nervous system. So though there is cephalation, that means the formation of head, but the brain-like structure is not developed yet. So they have a network of nerve fibers. So in Platyhelminthes, we can see that the nervous system is ladder-like, where the nerves are interconnected with the help of the transverse connection. Now, let us know about the reproduction in Platyhelminthes. They are hermaphrodite, that means they have both the male and female sex organs, but their body structure still undergo cross-fertilization and internal fertilization. Their development, it shows both direct and indirect development. So in direct development, there is no larval stage, example planaria, and in indirect development, there is larval stage, example tapeworm. Now, let us know about the classification in Platyhelminthes. So, Platyhelminthes is categorized into three classes. The first class is the tuberalia, example Dugesia convoluta. The second class is known as the trematoda, example Fasciola, Cystoma, and the last class is known as the Cestoda, example Tinea, Echinococcus. So